saying things people already know out loud is tight.
Avada Kedavra.
You park in front of your house, I park in front of my house.
This is...
Hey!
Truly delightful.
Oh, have we started already?
What is up, everyone? It's Adam from FWCI, and today I am embarking on a new journey. I want you guys to come along with me. I'm going to be watching from the first episode, The Mandalorian. Okay, so he's a bit of a badass.
I can bring you in warm.
Oh, he has a voice.
Or I can bring you in cold.
All right, so he's like a badass bounty hunter, I guess. Is that what Boba Fett was in the Star Wars? He looks like Boba Fett. Maybe I'm just looking like an idiot because I think there's some connection between the two, but... I also have no idea what time this set is set in, whether it's before or after. Okay, he doesn't like robots. So he's got the old Datsun 120Y, is that what this is?
The settler.
So is the Mandalorian like...
I'd stay off the ice if I were you.
Is he like Johnny Lawrence from Cobra Kai? He's just a technophobe? This monster is crazy, just... He looks like he has a hippopotamus mouth.
I like your ship. She's a
classic. I like this guy. Okay, Mandalorian is a he's stone cold. He's a stone cold dude. If he's even a dude, I don't even know what I'm watching.
It might take a while. I'm molting.
No, you're not. You're gonna try and escape. This is not a good move there, Fish Yondu. Life Day?
Maybe even,
The hell is that? Oh, it's Carbonite. I know that one. I know Carbonite.
Family. But I guess that's not gonna happen this year.
Probably not.
Oh, so Carbonite is a aerosol now, not a dipping. The Mandalorian also sounds like the guy who does the voice in the NWO entrance music from pro wrestling.
The following announcement has been paid for by the New World Order.
Okay, so this is like a super secret double black diamond mission I'm getting from that. But Billy D is the coolest man, cooler than the other side of the pillow. Oh, hello. Okay, so that's that little thing that he just got given. Okay, so that's just to get access to the person that is gonna give him the job. Right. Oh, stormtroopers. Well, he seems like a trustworthy, above board businessman to do deals with. Yeah. Oof. Ew. Jim Henson is a far cry from what that was. That did not look good. He's almost like the protagonist from a video game, because he doesn't speak much, and so far there's a lot of exposition in this episode. Oh, this is where he lives. I'm so confused trying to figure out what's going on in this one here. Oh! Is it a sexy lady Mandalorian?
It is good it is back with the tribe.
Yes.
Okay.
A pauldron would be in order. Has your signet been revealed?
Not yet.
Okay, so they're like a tribe of warriors, I guess? Okay, ooh. They're melting down the Beskar.
That's good. I was once a foundling.
I know.
sort of foundling, I'm guessing, is like a street kid that they take on and train up. Okay, so he's seen some death, maybe of his parents, I'm guessing. Shoulder pad? I love the zoom up close of the mask, like it's emoting some kind of, you know, feeling. Okay, so his helmet looks like it's that same Beskar as the shoulder pad.
I have spoken.
Jesus. Come on, spicy boy. This is more and more like a Western as it goes on. It seems very clear that's a big influence. I know that was the influence of Star Wars as well, but this in particular is like doubled down on that theme. Time for this. Easy. Calm down, spicy boy. Calm down.
Settle down. Whoa. Settle. Settle.
He has spoken. Not so much of a spicy boy anymore.
Then there will again be peace. I have...
This is a straight up cowboy show. So these guys are guarding the asset or the target or whatever we call it. Ooh, what's with the Mandalorian's fingers? They look like weird, like monster hands.
Subparagraph 16 of the Bondsman Guild Protocol waiver compels you to immediately produce said asset.
Shit. That rickety old robot's got some moves.
I'm in the guild!
You are a guild member. I thought I was the only one on assignment.
That makes two of us. So much for the element of surprise. Unless I am mistaken, you are, as of yet, empty-handed.
This is true.
I have a suggestion.
Proceed.
We split the reward.
This is acceptable. I will, of course, receive the reputation merits associated with the mission.
Can we talk about this later?
I require an answer. Alert.
The bureaucratic robot, I love it. Actually quite like the dynamic between the Mandalorian and the robot, like, you know, they're like rival professionals kind of thing. Like, it's a very unique way to tell that story. Uh-oh.
I will initiate self-destruct.
Stumped.
Beginning self-destruct countdown.
No. Cut it out. You're not gonna self-destruct.
Another fire, I'll take it out.
Acceptable.
Go!
No! Smooth move. Well done. I still feel like somebody wrote a Western and then they just made it space. Like, that's a Gatling gun. That's what that is. I played Red Dead. I know what a Gatling gun is.
I will disengage self-destruct initiative.
Good.
You know, you're not so bad for a droid.
Agreed.
That blaster head looks nasty. You
that's right. You don't like droids.
Running equipment has missed my central wiring harness.
Is that good?
Yes.
Well, the door open.
Does IG-11 stay around? Is that what's going on? Think I know who might be in there.
Perhaps it could live many centuries. Sadly, we'll never know.
No. We'll bring it in alive.
The commission was quite specific. The asset was terminated.
If possible, bring it in alive. That was the deal. No! Uh-oh. Well, that was The Mandalorian. Wow. So, all right, it was a lot more humor in that than I kind of expected there to be. You know, I guess I was kind of expecting it to be a bit more serious and stuff like that. But The Mandalorian, I guess I didn't even think, like, does he have a voice or not? He, you know, they've added a bit more personality to that character than what it sort of appears that they have, you know, before seeing the show. But that was a lot more entertaining than I thought it was going to be honest. I expected it to be good, I guess, but I didn't expect to, you know, be able to follow along with the story that much. I get a bit overwhelmed with a lot of sci-fi stuff. I'm not the best sci-fi watcher, which is why I've got my my notes written down here. Okay, so we've picked up the child in his little hover basket. And now we're just heading back to Mr. I Have Spoken. Which I found out is Nick Nolte. What the hell? Uh-oh. Compies, get out of there. He's a very cute character. Bravo to whoever designed Baby Yoda, because it looks adorable. What is that beeping? What is this child thinking? Can he use the Force already? And so did I just witness a little bit of rapport being built there between the child and the Mandalorian? Yeah, so this is like the iconic look, is it? With the floating basket and Mandalorian on foot with his cape and his hunting rifle thing. So I feel like that thing has been in a Star Wars movie before. That giant bus. Jesus. Come on, you're telling me that's not a scene that would happen with a horse and wagon in a Western? Come on. So because I'm watching this with subtitles on, it's telling me that these are Jawas. They look familiar, but I don't really know much about them. Shit. Oh, fuck. After all that. So the Mandalorians aren't so tough after all. You just need some electricity bullets. So would they get to his ship while he was... off getting the child? They got in there and messed with all his shit. Ah, damn it. The space Datsun 120Y is not looking in good shape. Oh, here we go. Are you gonna build the ship back together again, child? It's like he parked it in a bad neighborhood and came back and the ship was up on bricks and somebody had taken the rims. What's this guy gonna think about the child? He seems to know a lot.
I thought you were dead.
It's a very different relationship, but I was just watching something with Game of Thrones where Arya Stark and the Hound had sort of teamed up. And I get not the same vibes, because obviously the child and Arya Stark are very different characters, but, you know, I guess the Mandalorian and the Hound have some similarities, which I'm kind of digging.
They really don't like you for some reason.
Yeah.
Well, I did disintegrate a few of them.
These are actually quite cool, these little characters, these Jawas.
Drop your rifle.
I'm a Mandalorian. Weapons are part of my religion.
Then you are not getting your parts back.
Look at the last reaction. I said this is like a video game. This feels more like a video game now. You have to go and get the egg to get to the next level. But the fact that Mandalorian is huffing and puffing about it, you know, makes it a lot more funny. Oh, if I know anything about Star Wars, there's a giant monster in that hole. Uh-oh. That ain't good. Told you there was a giant monster in there. A spicy rhino. So you've got fire in one hand and a grappling hook in the other. So is he like a robot himself? And that way he's like... What was that spark? The music of this is crazy, by the way. Oof. Hey, here we go. And Mandalorian was like, I'm not going out without a fight. What did you do? What did you do, little baby Yoda? Oh, has he got something stuck in him? He's having a nap. He's had a big day of using the Force. Now it's nap time. It's the Mandalorian's weird... Are they gloves or has he just got, like, mutated hands? Oh yeah, the egg. Get that shit.
Mando!
Mando? Is that what we're calling him, is it?
I've got the egg.
So is it just the yummy, yummy yolk? That's a good egg for bacon and eggies. It was just a delicacy, Jesus Christ.
I'm surprised you waited.
I'm surprised you took so long.
Ugnaught is quite a, quite a hype man. He's the Bobby the Brain Heenan to Mr. Perfect.
Yes.
Was it injured?
I don't think so. Not physically.
Why am I getting vibes from
Explain
this guy now?
To me again. I still don't understand what happened.
Yeah, he's sus on the Force.
Neither do I.
All right, now we get us a montage.
Do.
I'm gonna insert some cooler montage music here.
I can't thank you enough. Please allow me to give you a portion of the reward.
I cannot accept. You are my guest. And I am therefore in your service.
It's a, quite a
generous bloke. I could use a quarter of your ability, and I can pay handsomely.
I am honored, but I have worked a lifetime to finally be free of servitude.
I understand.
But your life is to serve your guests.
All I can offer is my thanks.
And I offer mine. Oh. Thank you for bringing peace to my valley. May it survive and bring you a handsome reward.
May it survive?
I have spoken.
Yeah, I'm getting vibes from this fella. I... Time to get back to the home base. No, you gotta get back to the creepy dude with the stormtroopers. Oh, good morning. This artwork at the end here looks awesome. I'm guessing it's just a screen cap with a filter put over it or something, but yeah, that looks decent.
It's not a toy.
That helmet looks extremely cool. And the child looks extremely cute. See, I appreciate it when they write on the screen what planet they're going to. I don't know, it just helps me. Mando has arrived. His giant ears. So the child is just taking it all in. Learning, I guess. Or is this warning signs for the child? Guessing he doesn't just deliver it. He's gonna shoot his way out of there.
Easy with that.
You take it easy.
Bit of attitude from the stormtrooper. It's a lot coming from an extinct army of, you know, dudes that can't shoot.
This asset was of extreme importance to me. I had to ensure its delivery.
He also said kill it, so...
But to the winner go the spoilers.
Is that Beskar? A whole shit ton of it? Ooh, he could have more shoulder pads. That guy is impressively creepy. Oh no! You gonna let him take him, or... Alright, Mando. It's time to be a badass. Okay. That's good storytelling, I like that. Because even though I know that, you know, obviously the child is still around, because this show's been out for a long time. They still make me understand the stakes of what he's going through. Mushroom Hat. The soundtrack of this show is... very noticeably impressive. It stands out a lot. I got all that sweet, sweet Beskar.
That would be a great honor.
Who are these dudes creeping up?
I must warn you, it will draw many hours.
Our strength was once in our numbers. Now we live in the shadows and only come above ground one at a time.
Alright. Jesus. Okay, so it's not all... roses with the Mandalorian. I'm getting vibes that the Mandalorian are like a Native American influenced sort of character in the scope of the universe and this show.
I shall craft.
Ooh, fuck. This is actually quite intense, this episode. The last one was a little bit slower. But this one is learning a lot about Mando.
Them sparingly, for they are rare.
So what the hell is a whistling bird? Oh, they're like darts? Bullets or something? So it's in his armor now? I would feel like they would be happy to get the Beskar back that's got the Imperial stamp on it. As a sense of, like, you know, taking back their heritage or whatever. What's she making for him? Is this like new chest plate and new everything, or are we about to get Stormbreaker Star Wars stars? Oh, yeah.
I told you I'm not interested in your excuses. You had your shot, Dust Breather, but you failed. No pucks for you, now get out of here.
I'm pretty sure there was an expletive in there as well, by the way. Look at that shiny armor.
Mando!
Billy D. Williams is the best. I had no idea he was going to be in this either.
In their minds, but not me. No. That's the best of the lot. A nobleman's son skipped bail. Looks like you're headed to the ocean dunes of Karnak.
The ocean dunes of Karnak.
Any idea what they're gonna do with it?
With what?
Again.
I didn't ask. It's against the guild code.
They work for the Empire. What are they doing here?
The Empire is gone, Mando.
Is it though? Is it though? So we're getting to see Mando's, like, conscience, I guess, kick in, like that guilt or responsibility, or maybe something more cosmic, some sort of connection with the child, and he's just can't stop thinking about it. Ah, that was, yeah, the thing that the child was trying to eat. I remember those times. Come on, Mando. brilliant how they emote that helmet. Very, very well done. Yeah, here we go. That's the basket. That's not good. Oh, here we go.
Check the perimeter.
Sorry, Mandalorian, stormtroopers are here. With their saggy crotch plates. Do they make the stormtroopers more formidable in this one, or are they still kind of a joke? Enough said. He hit him! I feel like Mandalorian after this would be every, like, nerdy dad's Halloween go-to dream. That was a child approving that. I think he does. Alright, what shit's going on here? Hey! Nice. There's a bit of a price on your head, I see, Mr. DeLorean. Again, with the cowboy movie, you know, comparison, this is a wanted poster, you know?
The kid's coming with me.
If you truly care about the kid, then you put it on the speeder, and we'll discuss terms.
No droids.
Because I'm your only hope.
Princess Leia, see, I get some of the bigger references. Come on, Baby Yoda, make all these people fly, and then run. Shit.
Drive!
Fucking hell. Seriously, is this just a Western story that they've completely ripped off scene for scene? Because this is a horse and wagon, like... Hello, hello, who's this? Oh, it's his peoples. Yeah, because they're all beasts. Hey, there he is. Yeah, that guy's got a point to prove.
This is the way.
Okay. So, even though there's infighting, there's still a lot of loyalty and, you know, commitment to the cause, I guess.
Hold it, Mando.
Ah, shit. So the subtitles just said that was a different guy's name. So is that not Lando? Have I been thinking it's Lando the first three episodes? Why is he hoarding Beskar? Probably payment from the Empire for letting them set up shop. A classic.
I gotta get one of those.
Oh, please tell me his backpack gets jets. Come on, that's... Come on, that's adorable. So fuck the guild code is what I'm getting from this.
All of them.
Carl Weathers, not Billy Dee Williams. See, I don't know how much of this kind of thing they did in Star Wars, of just world building, like showing this, you know, alien wildlife and stuff, but I don't know, to me it helps build the foundation of, you know, where the show has taken place. Uh-oh. I've seen enough Jurassic Park The Lost World to know that this isn't good. Is this the T-Rex? Oh, shit. Laser T-Rex? Laser Raptors? That's an intense place to hide. No, not the blue prawns. This is just a mugging. See, I care more about the low-key destruction of this tiny village than I do about the exploding of an entire planet. Sanctuary.
Ah, here we go.
Stop touching things.
Did he put down the landing gear or something?
Ready to lay low and stretch your legs for a couple of months, you little womp rat? Nobody's gonna find us here.
Womp rat? I hope he's not a womp rat. Didn't Luke Skywalker murder small animals called womp rats? Okay, so is he gonna, like, anti-hero his way into helping these people?
Now listen, I'm gonna go out there and I'm gonna look around. It shouldn't take too long.
Now, I would not be leaving him
there. Anything. I'll find us some lodging, and I'll come back for you.
He's been touching.
Stay right here. You stay. Don't move. You understand? Great.
He's been touching shit the entire flight. Oof. The Mandalorian have great faith.
I want the hell. Come on.
In case there's another one of those rhinoceros things, I probably wouldn't mind having Baby Yoda with me. So in the scope of the Western movie, is this the hero going, like, over the border to Mexico or something like that? Ooh. Spicy boy. Very spicy.
What's your business here?
Business? Oh, well, there's not much business in Swanee, so I can't say. Doesn't strike me as a log runner.
Keep an eye on the kid.
Yes, sir.
I kind of like that lady. Look up. There it is. So that's the UFC girl from, that was in Deadpool. Oh my god, Mando. The flamethrower. Jesus.
Raiders. We have money.
So you think I'm some kind of mercenary?
You are a Mandalorian, right?
Or at least wearing Mandalorian armor. That is Mandalorian armor, right?
It is.
See? I told him.
These guys are like fanboys.
About your people, tribe. If half of what I read is
we
true,
we have money.
This is interesting. These guys seem genuinely like desperate and like downtrodden.
Well, looks like they're happy to see us.
Looks like.
Not often you get joy and happiness in a Star Wars property.
Can I feed him?
Sure.
Do you have any toads?
Sure.
Mando's already sick of this shit.
Do you mind if I ask you something?
Go ahead.
How long has it been since you've taken that off?
Does he smell?
Yesterday.
I mean, in front of someone else.
Jesus. It's a bit personal.
My parents were killed, and the Mandalorians took care of me.
Interesting. I don't know if I was supposed to know that yet or not, but I understand now. Mandalorians, it is a lot more like Batman than I realized.
ATST.
Imperial Walker. What's it doing here?
Oh, Imperial Walker. That's the chicken-looking ones, right? We're going to see Mandalorian and Gia Carano. Is that her name? Montage!
Unless we show them how.
Yeah! Training montage.
But when it steps in, it drops.
It's bulk strategy, Cotton. Let's see if it pays off.
Who knows how to shoot?
The shame. How do you know how to shoot?
Guts, guts and mind. Lifting weights and feeling alright. It's a showdown. Going down, how you gonna mess around? Showdown. Put your nose down. Showdown.
What?
Mando's like, what the fuck? Are they drinking prune juice? Prawn juice? Is that why it's all illuminated? Oh. There it is. Wow, they're really making the AT-ST, like, horrifying, terrifying, you know, force to go against. Yeah, remember this guy. Of course, and she's a rebellion soldier, so this would be a battle she would know far too well. Oh yeah, shit, Baby Yoda's there. Keep him safe. Feels like Game of Thrones final episode, or final season, I should say. That's a crazy move that they're portraying this thing like a dinosaur. Uh-oh. Ah, fuck. If you don't move, we can't see you. Is Baby Yoda gonna, like, snap the leg of this thing? Because old mate was saying, nothing in the universe can break the leg of these AT-STs.
I'll cover you.
Badass.
This is it, it's now or never.
She's a bit of a leader on the battlefield. There he goes. Alright, what's her deal? She's way too comfortable on the battlefield. And the village was saved. Baby Yoda got his frog. Give it to me! Nom, 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 nom.
Fits right in.
So what happens if you take that thing off? They come after you and kill you?
No. You just can't ever put it back on again.
That's it? So you can slip off the helmet and settle down with that beautiful young widow and raise your kids and you're sipping spotchka?
Uh-oh. Who's this with a fob? Uh-oh. No! Directed by Bryce Dallas Howard, holy shit. What are you doing in there, whatever your name is from Jurassic World? That was a really cool episode. I mean, it does seem to be like some episode, each episode set on like a different planet, almost. But that one was really fun because we got like a night, it's almost like a bottle episode. We meet these people at the start and, you know, we find out their struggle and we see their, you know, the impact, we get to know them, we, you know, help them. So it was a, another good, and this is what I'm saying about, I struggle with some Star Wars property because it feels like it just drops you in the middle of it. Whereas this, they, like maybe because it's a TV show and not a movie, they're taking the time to build these characters so you actually care about it. Because I think that was a genuinely heartfelt moment between Mando and a character whose name I don't even know. I just wrote down that her daughter was called Winter. That's all I know about him. But it was fantastic. They brought back the AT-ST as this like horror movie villain, almost like Tyrannosaurus Rex dinosaur type of thing, which I think that's awesome. I think clearly somebody said like, no, let's make it like a dinosaur. Let's make it like this, like, you know, let's make it like this monster that can just strike fear and intimidation even just through a simple movement. So I enjoyed that one quite a lot. We got more building between Mando and the child, obviously. I'm interested to see how the child processes all of this happenings, because the child is seeing everything happen and we're not seeing a great deal of character development from that character by design. That's exactly the intrigue that they're trying to set up. So I'm excited to see when the child really makes a point to, you know, establish some sort of grounds or some sort of position of how he sort of feels about things. But let me know what you guys thought in the comment about Mandalorian Season 1 Episode 4 Sanctuary, and drop a like and subscribe. And as always, everyone, be well, stay safe, look after your friends.